बैक लेट्स टॉक अबाउट हाउ टू यूज टाइमर इन स्विफ्ट यूआई, हाउ टू यूज टाइमर इन स्विफ्ट यूआई। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी गोना क्रिएट ऑन दिस स्विफ्ट यूआई व्यू कमांड एन एंड व्हिच हैव अ स्विफ्ट यूआई व्यू एंड टाइमर एग्जांपल व्हिच हैव अ स्विफ्ट यूआई व्यू नेम टाइमर एग्जांपल। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज टाइमर। A timer that fires after a certain time interval has elapsed, sending a specified message to a target object. Okay, and so if you want to sum code regularly, perhaps to make a countdown. Timer or similarly, you should use timer and receive modifier and timer and receive modifier. So first of all, we're gonna create on this timer, which have on this timer, and we can use of current date, which have a current date, and we can use of at the rate state. Current date, whichever this is a current date today. Sorry, today date. We can set note current date. This is a today date is equal to date. We shall create on this instance date. We can use of class date in this date. You create on this instance. Okay, date we can use of today date assign on this today date, and we're gonna get on the let timer. Timer object is equal to timer, and you can use of timer class on this timer, and timer which dot publish, we can use of dot publish every on in, we can use of every suppose which have a every interval time interval, we can use of every time interval, this is a suppose which have a one, and we can use of on, we can use of on, and dot main current and main current suppose we have use dot main, and we're gonna use of in parameter suppose which have a in parameter dot, we can assign on this tracking default and common suppose which have a common. Okay, and we're gonna use of dot assign on this dot interval options run loop suppose we can use auto connect, we can use the auto connect, and we're gonna create on this layout design suppose we can use of z stack, and we're gonna create on this extensions which have on this color, and we're gonna use of suppose this is a public static let, and which have timer bg background, which have a timer bg and is equal to color, assign on this color, and which have a red blue green initializers and opacity red blue green, which have initializer red blue green, and we can 0.9 to 5 okay, and which have on this green color suppose which have on this green color 0.941, and which have assigned on this blue color 0.953, okay, so this is a time is a text color, and which have assigned on the 0.482 assigned on the 0.482, this is a red color, and we can assign this blue color 0.5 0.2. We can assign in this blue color 0.549, which I'm assigning this 49. We're gonna create on this another color. This is a public static let timer shadow. We can assign this timer shadow color. Which have assigned this initializer red, blue, green. Then we're gonna assign on this properties 1.000, 1.000. This is a red, and we're gonna assign on this green. Suppose which have on this green 1.000, 1.000, and we're gonna assign this 1.000. This is a timer shadow color, okay? And we're gonna create on this timer shadow color, and we're gonna assign on this. Suppose this is a background color, so color. Dot timer bg, timer bg, we're gonna send dot ignoring safe area, ignoring safe area dot all. We're gonna resume on this application, okay? And we're gonna create on this VStack design. We're gonna create on the design outlet template. We're gonna create on the VStack and use of text bind on this property. This is a bind on this property. And this command we can use of bind on this property, okay, which have assigned on this value string interpolation, and this is a timer current date, so this is a today date assign on this today date, okay. Assign on this today date is create on this today date, and we're gonna apply on this property. Suppose this is a title, we're gonna apply on this title. And we're gonna apply on this color is, we can apply on this weight. Suppose which have dot, we're gonna apply on this weight. This is a heavy weight, we're gonna apply on this heavy weight. And we're gonna apply on this color, this is a green color. Not apply on this green color. Suppose which have on this ability timer, we can add on timer text color. Assign this timer text color, and we're gonna apply on this timer text color, and we're gonna apply on this dot on receive method only. We're gonna apply dot on receive method on receive method, and we're gonna apply on this text. Suppose on receive method, and what we can assign on this timer object, assign on this timer object, and this is the input. This is the input, but is the timer object with the performance remove on this perform. Then remove on this. This is the input. This is a new value. Input value, okay, in input value, in this is a current today date, we can assign this today date and is equal to input value. Assign on this input value today date, we're gonna assign on this input value, okay. And assign, suppose we're gonna apply on this VStack dot padding, we're gonna apply on this dot frame. We're gonna apply on this dot frame, we stack on this dot, we're gonna apply on this frame, this 200 width, and we're gonna apply on this height is 150, height on this 150, and we're gonna apply on this height is 150, and we're gonna apply on this height is 150, we're gonna apply on this corner radius. Suppose this is a corner radius, apply 16.0, we're gonna apply on this shadow, we're gonna apply on this shadow. Suppose we're gonna apply on this dot shadow color, this is we can set on this color first shadow, so I cut in the color dot, we're gonna assign on this color dot timer shadow color, timer shadow color dot opacity. Suppose which have opacity 0.2, assign on the opacity 0.2, and we're gonna assign on the radius is, suppose which have assign on this radius is 6, we're gonna assign this 6 radius, and we're gonna apply on this 10 and 10, which have in the x is 10 and is the y is 10, okay. And we're gonna apply on this shadow dot shadow, which have on this color, another color is we can use of another shadow. This suppose we can use of another shadow, but it's not minus value. We can use of another shadow is shadow dot color. We can set on this color, color dot shadow color timer shadow color dot opacity. suppose opacity is 0.2, 0.2 assign on this opacity, and we can assign on this radius. Suppose radius is 6, and we can assign on this minus 10, and minus 10x and minus 10y. Assign on this minus 10x and minus 10y. Okay, we're gonna running on this project. This is not apply on this. Is that is issue on this apply, which is not apply on this issue. Suppose we have what is issue, check on this issue on this screen. Suppose we have on this check on this issue on this screen. Suppose one day is 18.2, we can use a current date. Timer BG, we can check on this timer BG value at color extensions. We're gonna run on this project. And this is a not apply on this background color. And we're gonna apply on this VStack frame and counter-rated dot background color. We can apply on this color, shift color dot white. We're gonna apply on this color dot white. And you're gonna apply on this corner radius, and you can set on this color dot white, and you're gonna apply on this corner radius command X. Assign on this corner radius, and we're gonna assign on this corner radius. Okay, we're gonna renew on this project. Okay, we're gonna renew on this project. Suppose we have on this, we can assign on this width, not apply on this 200, and width. Suppose we can apply on this 200 and width. Sorry, we're gonna apply on this 280 width, and we're gonna apply on this height. Is suppose this is a 180 height. Okay. We're gonna run this standard shadow on the supply. This is a timer. This is a Friday, July 9. Today's date, Friday, July 9, 2021. At 1:11, 1:34, 1:31 is time. AM for the 4 second increase. India standard time. This is a India standard time. We can use a timer BG, and we can use a timer BG, and another statement. We can background color of timer C. Okay. We're gonna assign this video. So if you want to some run code regularly, and we can assign on this some code regularly, and we can change on this color. Suppose this is the time remaining set on this timer. So timer, a timer that fires after a certain time interval has left sending a specified message to the target. Suppose we can assign on this timer remaining. We're gonna get on this property. We're gonna assign this timer remaining. State private var timer remaining, time remaining, we can okay, and we're gonna assign on this 50 second. Okay, timer ringing state property, we're gonna assign this 50, and we're gonna remove on this text element, remove on this onReceive method. So this is the onReceive method, and timer object, we can assign on this timer object, and input value. Suppose we not apply on this input value, this is the underscore, assign on this underscore, and we're gonna apply on this conditions. If condition, we're gonna apply on this timer remaining is greater than equal to 0, we're gonna assign on this timer remaining, and is equal minus equal to 1. Okay, so we're gonna run on this project minus equal to 1, and we're gonna apply on this timer remaining is bind on this text in this timer remaining. And we're gonna apply on this timer remaining. Try again. This is the regime on this applicant. This is a 50, 21, 23, 41. This is the timer remaining, 50 second, 41, 45, 46. Which I have not applied on this color. Color is the text color, means the red color. Okay, we're gonna apply on this 21, 41, 42, 47. So, if you want to run some code regularly, perhaps to make countdown. This is a countdown property. Come 41, 40, 31, 30. Countdown. We can second. We can apply. So suppose we can set on this. Second is 6 second. Okay. We can apply 6 second. Resume on this application. Within 6 second. Apply on this 6 second. Okay. 6th, 5th, and 4th. And we can apply 3 and 2 and 1. Okay. In 0. We can just countdown is 0. We can last element of countdown. So. A timer that fires after a certain time interval has elapsed sending a specified message of target object. If you want to run on subcount regularly, perhaps to make countdown timer and use of SwiftUI timer. So thank you for watching this video. We can use of enjoy timer in SwiftUI.